Kim Kardashian is one of the most prominent influencers on social media today. She's famous for her TV shows, her fashion, and of course, her selfies. At one point, Kim K had taken so many selfies that she actually gave herself a very painful wrist injury. Welcome back, everybody. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Nick Gallo, and I'm a doctor of physical therapy. With today's video, I want to discuss the Kim Kardashian wrist injury that she sustained after taking too many selfies. With today's video, I want to start by first talking about her official medical diagnosis, the specific anatomical structures that are involved, why this injury happened to her specifically, and ways that she can prevent this injury in the future. If you like today's video, please give me a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. I will be doing more videos in the future regarding injuries, rehabilitation, and physical therapy related content. Back in 2018 on Keeping Up with the Kardashians, fans learned that Kim Kardashian injured her wrist from taking too many selfies. She had taken a record number 6,000 selfies in one weekend, which resulted in this wrist injury. Her wrist pain became so severe that she actually had to hire a selfie assistant to give her adequate time to heal. Because she suffered the injury, the condition became known as Kim Kardashian wrist or selfie wrist. The medical diagnosis that Kim received, however, is something that most of us have heard of, and that is carpal tunnel syndrome. Now, before we go over the diagnosis and the anatomical structures involved, let's take a look at this clip from Keeping Up with the Kardashians. Here, Kim reveals that her hand is hurting in the position that she's holding her cell phone. She's holding it in a position known as wrist flexion, as the phone is bending back towards her. Pain becomes so severe that she has to have an assistant come over and actually record for her. It was revealed that she was diagnosed with carpal tunnel syndrome. To fully understand the diagnosis, it's important to understand the anatomy first. The carpal tunnel is a narrow passageway on the palm side of the wrist that will connect the forearm to the hand. Carpal bones and the flexor retinaculum make up the borders of the carpal tunnel. However, it's important to note that the median nerve and 9 tendons flow through the tunnel. The space is so small that if any of the 9 tendons begin to swell, this can cause further narrowing of an already small space. This can result in compression of the median nerve within the carpal tunnel. If this happens, then the person is given the medical diagnosis of carpal tunnel syndrome. There are many causes of carpal tunnel syndrome, however, one that is very common is known as repetitive stress injury. In this clip with Jimmy Kimmel, Kim shows him how she takes her selfies. She holds her wrist in a position of extreme flexion, thus causing compression on that median nerve. The act of doing this over and over and over again results in that repetitive stress injury. The longer that she holds this position and the more times that she does it, she is further increasing the compression on that median nerve. Over time, this will result in wrist pain and hand numbness, which are common signs and symptoms associated with carpal tunnel syndrome. Due to the nerve distribution of the median nerve, numbness and tingling are commonly felt in the yellow areas. The areas include the thumb, index, and middle fingers, and half of the ring finger. It's important to note, however, if somebody is feeling wrist pain and any numbness or tingling in the hands, to get a formal medical diagnosis from a licensed medical professional first. Getting carpal tunnel syndrome by taking too many selfies is not just unique to Kim Kardashian, however. Medical professionals are noticing a trend in treating the general population. Therefore, everybody should be cognizant in remaining in a neutral wrist position when using their cell phones. Doing so will provide adequate spacing for the median nerve within the carpal tunnel.
So in summary, although Kim Kardashian did suffer wrist injury from taking selfies, her medical diagnosis is something that's fairly common, known as carpal tunnel syndrome. Fortunately, in Kim's case, she did not require surgery. Usually, for an individual to recover from carpal tunnel syndrome, it's just going to require time of keeping your wrist out of those painful positions where the median nerve is compressed. So in terms of carpal tunnel syndrome, those positions include anything with the wrist abnormally flexed too much, and the person is really encouraged to keep their wrist in a general straight position. If the median nerve has been compressed for long amounts of time, this can change the time that it takes for a person to heal. Depending on this length of compression, recovery time can take anywhere from weeks to months. One part of the recovery process involves splinting, which Kim Kardashian did receive. Recovery also involves getting physical therapy to strengthen, stretch, and heal the wrist and hand. If carpal tunnel syndrome is so severe and a person is not improving with physical therapy and splinting, then surgery might be indicated. A typical surgical process in this involves something known as a carpal tunnel release surgery. Essentially, what the surgeon is going to do is they're going to go in and they are going to provide more additional space for that median nerve to freely move around in. But it is important to know that most cases of carpal tunnel syndrome can heal without surgical intervention. And that's it for the Kim Kardashian wrist injury. Thank you very much for watching this video again. If you did like it and you found today very informative, please hit that subscribe button because I will be making more videos in the future. Take care and I'll see you next time. Also, if you have any comments or suggestions on today's video or any future injuries that you see, please put that in the comment section below.